lecture. So this is the pseudo code for the insertion fault, which we will take and we will analyze it with the help of an example. First we will see like what is insertion fault and why it is called insertion fault. So like if you have some random numbers in an array, or if you have some random numbers, so with the help of sorting algorithms you can sort this given input in something of the form like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 9. So it is in increasing order, or you can sort this number in the form of like this also, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. So this is in decreasing order. So the basic purpose of sorting is to sort the number either in increasing order or decreasing order according to your suitability. So we will take an example and let's see how this thing will run. So first we will see like how this basically will work. So the basic thing without the actual going into the code, first I will tell you what is insertion sort and how it will work. So now let's take some So this is you can compare the insertion sort algorithm with a deck of cards. Suppose you have a deck of playing cards. So what will you do? You will take one card from the table and just all the cards are being placed towards the top, from up to down, such that you cannot see any of the cards. They are upside down. So you will take the first card and put it in your hand. So you will put it the first card in your left hand. Now you take the another card and just compare with the card in your hand and see whether it is greater or whether it is less. And you put the second card. It depends whether you want to arrange it in decreasing order or increasing order. Now you will take the other third card and compare where we have to insert this card, whether in between, whether to the right or whether to the left. So we will compare it. If it is greater then we will shift it to the left, and if it is like greater then you can shift it to the right card. So now this is how the insertion sort works. Like you are taking the fourth card, or you will see like all the cards in my left hand are already sorted. So now you take the fourth card and see where we have to put this card. It is greater than, or it will be lies in between the line between these two cards, or it will be lesser than the fourth card or something like that. So it is like arranging the cards, arranging the playing cards. So that's why it is called insertion sort. So now I will take an example of this card only. So I will first place the game. I am just taking this card. I am just taking this card in my hand, in my left hand, like this. This is eighth card. It's already there. So I do not need to sort this because there is no other card. So now what next thing I will do? I will take the next card, this sixth one. I will put it in my right hand. The sixth card is in my right hand, and I will compare it with the eighth number, whether it is larger or smaller. So what it will do, like 6 is less than 8. So what it will do, we have to know 6 is less than 8. So what is the procedure is that if the number is lesser, then we have to shift the bigger number towards the right. Shift the 8 here and place the number 6 here. So 6 and 8 are already sorted. Now we will take the third number 5 in our hand. So what we have done, we have taken the number 5 in our right hand and we will compare it with the already sorted numbers in our left hand side. So we have already taken this number, so it will go from here. So now we will compare. 5 is less than 8, it is 2. Like 8 is bigger than 8. So what we will do, we will shift this number to this here. So we have shifted this number to here. And now what we will do, we will place 5 here. No, we will not place 5 here because we have to compare it with this 6 also. So 5 is less than 6, true. So we have to shift 6 also. So 6 will be shifted here. And now the only place for 5 is 8. So now as you can see, 5, 6 and 8 are already sorted. So now we will come to our another number, that is 0. So we will take 0 outside and we will compare it with all the 3 remaining elements. So we will compare 0 with 8. 0 is less than 8, true. So we will shift 8 and put, so we will shift 8. So this is empty, so we will shift 8 here. So now we will compare 0 with 6. So 0 is less than 6, true. So we will shift 6 also. So now we will compare the last element 5. So 0 is less than 5, well, true. So we will shift 5 here. So 0 will be placed here. So as you can see that our 4 numbers are already sorted. 0, 5, 6 and 8. Now we will see 2. So we will put this out and put it here like 2. And now we will compare with all the rest of the elements. So 2 is less than 8, well, true. So we will shift this 2. Our right hand side. So now we will compare 2 with 6. 2 is less than 6, very true. So we will also shift this to right. Now we will compare 2 with 5. So it is already there. So we will shift 5 also. Now 2 is less than 0. No, it is false. So we will, as soon as the condition became false, we will put the number here. So now we have got all the 5 numbers sorted. So now we will take another iteration also, like 9. So 9 is, so our key will, so we will remove it from here. And now our value that needs to be compared is 9. So 9 is greater than 8. 9 is less than 8. This is false. So it does not need any swap or any movement. So 9 will remain here only. Because it is already sorted, so we do not need to compare it with other elements also. As we have already compared it with 8 and it is already greater, so we do not need any swap and comparison. So the next number that we will take is 1. So we need the comparison from 1. So like 1 is less than 9, true. So we have to shift this. So we have to shift this and the 9 will come here. 8 is less than 1, very good. So 8 also needs shift. 6 is less than 1. Very true. It also needs the same. 5 is less than 1, it also needs a shift and comparison. 1 comparison, 1 shift. 2 is less than 1, it is also true, so we need 1. Now we compare 0. 0 is less than 1, it is not true, so we will put 1 here as soon as the comparison ends. So all these till 7 we have sorted the list. Now we will compare 3. So we will put the 3 out from this block like it is in my right hand. So I will compare all the in my right hand number 3 is there. So what I will do, I will compare this 3 with all the cards in my left hand. So these are the cards that are in my left hand. So what I will do, I will compare this 3 with all the elements in my left hand. So 3 is compared with 9. So 3 is compared with 9, it is already less. So what we will do, we will just we will put 9 here. We compare 3 with 8, so it is already, it will be 8. As we compare 3 with 6, it is also less, so it will be 6 here. We have already shifted it here. 3 is compared with 5, so it is also less than 5, so 5 is here. 2 is compared with 3, 3 is greater, so we will put 3 here. So as you can see, we have now compared only the last element, that is 4, with the rest of the list. So as you can see, 4 is in my right hand side. 4 is with me on the right hand side. Now I will compare with all the elements in my on the cards in my left hand. So I will just take it out and compare it with all the rest of the elements. So 4 is compared with 9. So it is lesser. So what I will do, I will shift this. Now 8 is compared with 4, it is also less. It is shifted. 6 is compared with 4, it is also, 4 is less than 6, so 6 is shifted. Now 4 is compared with 5, it is also, 4 is less than 5, so 5 will be shifted. Now 3 is also compared with 4. So but it is what? 4 is greater than 3. So it will be placed here. So as you can see, we got a list sorted in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 9 according to our insertions on. So we will analyze the code part later in the. Hi friends, this is the continuation to the first lecture. So in the previous lecture we have seen that how the insertion sort is working, but we have not seen the pseudo code that how it is working. So in this lecture I will tell you that how this pseudo code is working according to our example. So first we will see, like, this is the first for loop. The for loop is starting from I is equals to 2 to b dot length. B is our an array where we have taken all the numbers in the array. So it is we are looping from I is equals to 2 to b dot length I plus plus. Like, we are iterating every element one after the other. So we have started from I is equals to 2. Like, there is a reason, because as we take first card in our left hand, so this first card does not need any attention. This first card does not need to compare or does not need to be swept first time. So that's why we have started our loop from I is equals to 2. So now let's see how this is working. So our first step is value is equals to bi. So I is equals to 2. So I will just, I is here from 2 location. So I have also indexed this, all these numbers from 1 to 9. So our I value is 2. Now we will take value. Value is equals to b of I. B of I means b of 2, that will be 6. So we will just store our value 6 here. It's not like I am rubbing this number, so this space is empty. Till now the space is not empty, I have taken it outside. Like, I have saved this number because in later stages of program we might encounter a case where we need to swap the number to this place. So we are just saving it so that we can value will not get overridden. So actually 6 is there only, but we have taken a copy. V is equals to 6 and 6 is also here. So this is we have value is equals to bi. It's this j is equals to I minus 1. So this is the another value, j. So j is equals to I minus 1. We have to compare all the values that are to the left of 6. That are all the values that are left to the 6. That's why we have taken j is equals to I minus 1. So our first condition, while j is greater than 0. So in our case, we will just see one after the other. J is equals to 1, that is greater than 0. The condition is fine. Now the next condition is b of j. B of j is what? B of 1. That value is 8. Is greater than value. So 8 is greater than 6. That is true. So what we will do? We will enter this loop. So what this loop will do? B of j plus 1 is equals to b of j. So b of j plus 1 will be b of 2 is equals to b of 1. So b of 1 is what? 8. So b of 2 will be equals to 8. So this step typically means to just copy the previous element to the next element. So this thing will become 8. So now this relevance will come, because we have overridden the value of 6. So that's why we have saved this value here only. So we will just see how this will work. We have overridden this value and we have saved this value, so we are safe. So this step is clear. Now j is equals to j minus 1. So j minus 1 will become 0. Now j will become 0. So now we will just, j is greater, 0 is greater than 0. So this while condition will break and we have to run this. B of j plus 1 is equals to value. So b of 1 will become 6. So b of 1 will become 6. So in this case we have sorted these two numbers. Now we will iterate. This loop will continue. For I is equals to 3. So we will remove all those things. Now the I will become 3. Now value is equals to b of 3. So what is b of 3? B of 3 is 5. Now we have taken b of I is equals to b of 3 is 5. Now what we will do, j is equals to I minus 1. As I have told you that we have to compare all the elements that are before the ith element. So j will come here. Now j is greater than 0, j value is 2 and it is greater than 0, that is fine. Now b of j is what? 8. And 8 is greater than 5. B of j is greater than value, b 8 is greater than 5, true. So it will enter this loop. So what this loop will do? B of j plus 1 is equals to b of j. So what it will do, it will just move to the next block. So 8 will come here. So now we have two elements, second and third elements, both contains the value 8, as 5 is overridden. So that is fine. Now j is equals to j minus 1. So what we will do, j value will come here. J is equals to j minus 1. What we will do next is, 1 is greater than 0, definitely true. And b of j is 6. 6 is greater than value, 6 is greater than 5, that is also true. So what we will do, so that is fine. So now we will what we will do, we will enter into the loop. So b of so now what we will do, so now what we will do, b of j plus 1 is equals to b of j. So what it will do, it will copy this element here. This is 8. So now j is equals to j minus 1. So j value will become here. So why now j is greater than 0? No. Now this condition is false, and now we will come to this function, b of j plus 1 is equals to value. Now what is the value of j? J value is 0, and b of 0 plus 1 is equals to 5. Yani ki b1 is equals to 5. So b of 1 will become 5 here. So as you can see, we have iterated through the 3 steps. Now the I value will become 4. I will be here, and j value will be I minus 1, as we can see. And now the value will become 0. While j is greater than 0, that is obvious the case. J is greater than 0, and b of j is what? 8. B of 3 is equals to 8. And b of 8 is greater than 0. That is true. So what we will enter this loop, and what we will do, we will shift this element. So we will shift 8 here. 8 is now here also and here also. So what now j will become j minus 1. So what will j will come here. So now it will enter again. Now j value is 2. So 2 is greater than 0, true. And b of 2, and it means it 6 is greater than 0, it is also true. So what we will do, we will shift this element to this place. So now 6 will be shifted to this location, and j is equals to j minus 1. Now the j will come here, and now we will enter the loop again. Now the j value is 1, and 1 is greater than 0, and b of 1 is 5. 5 is also greater than 0. So we will enter this loop, and what we will do, we will shift this element to the right. So we have shifted this element to the right. So what we will do now, j is equals to j minus 1. Now what will j become? J will come here. Now the j value is 0. So we will enter again the loop. J is greater than 0. Now 0 is not greater than 0. So we will break this loop, and b of j plus I or b of 1 is equals to 0. So now the 0 will come here. Now I is equals to 4 is done. Now we will move to I is equals to 5. Now I will move here. Now this is the I value, and the j value is before the I value. Now what is the value of b of I? B of I value is 2. Now we will compare the second element with all the other elements that are remaining. Now what is this j? J is equals to I minus 1, that we have already done. J is greater than 0, definitely b of j. Now 8 is greater than 2, this is definitely true. So what we will do, we will just shift this element to this place, 8, that is fine. Now what we will do, j is equals to j minus 1, so j will be, j will come here. Now we will again check that 3 is greater than 0. Yes, 3 is greater than 0. What is the value of b of 3? It is 6. 6 is greater than 2. Yes, 6 is greater than 2. So what we will do, we will just shift one element towards the right. So we will just shift this element towards the right. So that is fine. Now we will decrease the value of j. So again, what we have done, we have decreased the value of j to this location. So now what is the value of j now? 2. 2 is greater than 0, that is true. Now b of 2. What is b of 2? B of 2 is 5. 5 is greater than 2. Yes, it is definitely true. Now what we will do with this step, we will just shift the 5 to the next block. Now this element will become 5. And what we will do, we will reduce the value of j. So now j will come here. So now j value is 1. 1 is greater than 0, that is true. Now b of 1 is 0. 0 is greater than 2. 0 is greater than 2. This condition will become false and we will not enter this loop. So now what we will do, b of 1 plus 1, yani b of 2 will become, yani j value is 1, b of 1 plus 1 is equals to 2, or b of 2 is equals to 2. B of 2 will become, now our 2 value will be inserted here. So as we have seen, we have already sorted half of our list, only now some portion is left. Now what will I will be, value will become, I value will become 6. This is our I value. So now we will compare how it will work. So now the j value will become here. J value will be I minus 1. And our value will become now 9. I value, b of value is equal to b of I. So this will be 9. So now what we will do, while j is greater than 0. J is greater than 0. That is definitely true. 5 is greater than 0. And b of 5 is 8. 8 is greater than 9. This is true. So our while loop will break. We will not go inside this while loop and it will break. And what we will do, b of j plus 1 is equals to value. So b of j is 5 plus 1 is 6 and b of 6 is 9. So we do not need to change anything. This will remain here only. So we will go back again to the loop. Now our I value will become, we will increment our I value and j value will be 1 less than the I value. So and value will become 1. Now we need to compare 1 with all the elements that are to the left of this array. So what we will do, 1 is, now what we will do, j. 1 is, now we were, like now we will compare b of j. 9 is greater than 1. 9 is greater than 1, that is true. So what we will do with this step, we will just shift this element towards here. So now we have 2 9s in 6th and 7th position. Now what we will do, j is equal to j minus 1. Now this j will decrement. Okay. So now we will compare another. J is greater than 0, that is true. B of j. Now what is b of j? B of j is 8. 8 is greater than 1, that is also true. So what we will do? We will do a, we will go inside this loop and what we will do? We will just shift this to the towards the right. What this will do? It will just shift the element and it will decrease the j value. What is the j value? J b of we are here, like now the j value is 4. Now what is b of 4? B of 4 is 6. 6 is greater than 1? Yes, 6 is greater than 1. So what we will do? We will shift this number. So here 6 will come. And what next step we will do? J is equal to j minus 1. So what it will do? We will decrement the j value. Now this will become j. Now the j value is 3. J is now 3 is greater than 0? True. Now b of 3 is 5. 5 is greater than 1? Yes, true. So what we will do? We will shift the 5 and decrement the value of j. this, now this will be our j. Now j value is 2. 2 is greater than 0 and 2 is greater than 1. That is also true. Now what we will do? We will shift the 2 to the right. And what we will do? We will decrement the value of j. Now what is the value of j? 1. 1 is greater than 0 and 0 is greater than value? False. 0 is not greater than 1. 0 is not greater than 1. This is wrong. So what we will do? We will came out of this while loop, and what we will do? B of 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. Yani ki B of 2 will become 1. So our this routine will become like this. Now what we will do, we will come to the for loop again, and what we will do, we will increment our I value, it will be here, and what we will do, what will be the j will be I minus 1, it will be here, and what will be the next step? Now the value will become, v value will become 3. Now what we will do, we will check whether j value is greater than 0, j value is greater than 0, that value is 7, and what is the value of b of j? B of j is 9. So 9 is greater than 3, that is 2. So what we will do? We will shift it. Now the here it will become 9. And j is equals to j minus 1. What we will do? J will decrement. Now this will become j. So now what we will do? This 6 will be greater than 0 and b of j. Yani ki 8 is greater than 3, that is also true. What we will do? We will shift it. This will become 8. This is also 8 only now. And what we will do, we will decrement the value of j. Now we have decremented the value of j again. Now we will compare, j is greater than 0, that is true. Now b of j, that value is 6, 6 is greater than 3, that is also true. Now what we will do, we will just copy this element to the next, to the right. This element will become 6. And j is equal to j minus 1. Now this value will all again decrease and it will become j. Now what we will do? We will check j is greater than 0, that is true. Now b of j, what is b of j? B of 4, b of 4 is 5, 5 is greater than 3, definitely. So what we will do? We will just copy this to the next element and decrement the counter of j. Now this there comes again the j value is 3, j value is greater than 3 is greater than 0, and b of j. Now what you see, b of j is what? B of 3. B of 3 is 2. 2 is greater than 3, it is false. So what it will do? It will terminate the while loop and it will exit the loop, and what it will do? Our value is 3. And now our j value is also 3. So 3 is greater than 0 and b of j is what? B of 3 is equals to 2. 2 is greater than 3, it is false. So what it will do? It will not go inside the while loop and it will print b of 3 plus 1 is equals to value. What is this? B of 4 is equals to 3. So b of 4 will become 3. So it will for loop again, and what it will do, it will, now the I will increment and j will become I minus 1, and the key will become, the value will become 9. So what it will do, now what we will do, now j is greater, 8 is greater than 0 and b of j, meaning 9 is greater than value, yes, 9 is greater than 4, it is 2. What we will do? We will just shift the value to the right column with this. Now j will become j minus 1. We will loop through the array. So our I value will increment from here to, now our I value will become this. Our j value will become this, I minus 1. While j is greater than 0, j is greater than 0, and b of j, yani b of 8 is 9. 9 is greater than 4. 9 is greater than 4. So it will go inside the loop, and what it will do? It will just replace the next element value. One more thing, now the value is 4. So now the 9 will be here. Now 9 will be printed. Now 9 will occupy the same space and j will become j minus 1. So So what we will do, this will become j minus 1, j. Now j value is 7, 7 is greater than 0, that is true. B of 7, b of 7 is 8, 8 is greater than 4, that is also true. So what we will do, we will copy this element here and decrement the value of j. Now the j values became 6, 6 is greater than 0 and b of 6 is what? 6. 6 is greater than 4, yes, very true. Now what we will do, we will copy this element here and we will decrement the j counter. Now the j value is 5, it is greater than 0 and b of 5 is greater than value, 5 is greater than 4, that is true. What we will do, we will just copy this element to the next element. Now what will now we will just decrement the value of j. Now the j value is 4. Now what j is greater than, any 4 is greater than 0 and b of j is what? 3. 3 is greater than 4, that is not true. So what we will do, this while loop will get terminated and we will do b of j plus 1, any b of j is 4 plus 1 is equals to value is what? 4. So b of 5 is 4. So what we will do, so what happens is, now we have a sorted list which will be like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 9. So this is how all this insertion sort is working. So in the next lecture we will discuss about the time complexities, the space complexities and other forms of insertion sort, that if instead of array we can use linked list, or if we can reduce this, the time complexity or space complexity, things of insertion sort. So for now we will stop here. In the next lectures we will continue to discuss the insertion sort in some more details. Thank you.